Ma Rainey's Black Bottom is a 2020 American drama film directed by George C. Wolfe and written by Ruben Santiago-Hudson, based on the 1982 play of the same name by August Wilson. The film stars Viola Davis, Chadwick Boseman, Glynn Turman, Colman Domingo, and Michael Potts. Inspired by the career of Ma Rainey, an influential blues singer and the title character, the film dramatizes the turbulent recording session in 1920s Chicago. Produced by Denzel Washington, Todd Black, and Dany Wolf, the project was originally announced alongside Washington's Fences in 2013 as part of his 10-picture deal with HBO. Adaptation eventually moved to Netflix, and filming began in Pittsburgh of 2019. Boseman died during the post-production in August 2020, making Black Bottom his final film appearance. The film is dedicated to his memory. Ma Rainey's Black Bottom began a limited theatrical release on November 25, 2020, before beginning to stream on Netflix on December 18th. The film received universal acclaim. Critics lauded the performances of Davis, Boseman, Turman, as well as the costume design and production values. It was named one of the best 10 films of 2020 by the American Film Institute. The film received 5 nominations at the 93rd Academy Awards, including Best Actor for Boseman, Best Actress for Davis, and won 2 awards for makeup and hairstyling and costume design. Additionally, the film received 8 Critics' Choice Movie Award nominations and 9 NAACP Image Award nominations, including Outstanding Motion Picture, with Davis and Boseman both winning Lead Acting Awards. Davis and Boseman also won Lead Acting Awards for their performances at the Screen Actors Guild Awards, making history as the first black actors to win in leading categories in the same year. Both received nominations at the Golden Globes, with Boseman posthumously winning the Best Actor for a Motion Picture Drama film. Now, this movie is framed by a pair of powerhouse performances. Ma Rainey's Black Bottom plays an affectionate tribute to the blues legend and black culture at large. Boseman's performance in this film is absolutely outstanding. He imparts the seething, shattered man with the gift of a broken soul. He's driven by anger and trauma, and it makes him all the more human for it. And his final moments of screen time are among the darkest, yet some of the finest of his acting career. It's a poignant tribute to what a wonderful actor he was. August Wilson's dialogue is absolutely crackling, and the jazzy pace is on par with the music. And above all, the movie amounts to a solid resurrection and doesn't mess up what the play was originally about in the first place. Davis plays the real-life Ma Rainey, the Georgia singer dubbed the Mother of Blues. And once again, she turns out a magnificent performance as the jaded, cynical old blues singer who's been around the block so many times and knows exactly how to get things done. Boseman invests his body and soul into playing Levy, the hot-headed trumpeter who dares to lock horns with Ma in a shabby Chicago recording studio, where they are paid to make music the way white bosses wanted it made. The time is 1927, but the bristling racial tensions feel as timely as ever, as you see these talented musicians downtrodden by the business ethics, rather than letting their creative juices flow. For me, without a doubt, Boseman should have definitely won the Oscar for playing this character. Not because of his untimely death, but it's such a powerful, fantastic acting performance, and he fully deserved that year's Oscar for this role. Unfortunately, it was not to be, but hopefully people will always remember this as one of his finest acting performances. This is a haunting film, so detailed and moving, simple and to the point, yet also multi-layered. It's completely outstanding, particularly the phenomenal performances from the two leads. And not only does it speak towards the infighting within the band as they try to create music, it also speaks to the downtrodden aspects of black society, particularly within America. This is definitely a film worth watching, just to see Chadwick's final performance alone. Ma Rainey's Black Bottom gets an 8 out of 10.